also just so cozy and wholesome. It's all second-hand books, so you can get a paperback for about £2 to £3, or the hardbacks were about £8 to £9. But there were some really good finds in there. I would say it's the kind of place you probably wouldn't go to with a specific book in mind, but maybe more like an author in mind, where you could find some examples of their work. It's got a few different sections. It's got an A to Z author section, a graphic novel comic book section. It's got like a snug where there's a fire and a sofa, which is really, really cute. It's also got some folio books, although I can't say as I knew many of the titles that they had. And sort of new in section as well, and some audio books. But it also has a super, super cute cafe. So you can buy cakes and soups and sandwiches, toasties, various things like that. And then you can eat them in the yurt, which is very, very wholesome and such a nice experience, especially when you've bought some books and you can just have a look over them. So all in all, I really, really enjoyed it. It's got lots of lovely plants and flowers as well, and the staff. Compared to Jane Austen. So I think it's going to be quite a cool set in Sussex in 1912. So I think the place where they live in this superstitious town sounds really interesting. It's where the estuary meets the sea. So it paints a nice picture of their like sort of gloomy landscape. Steve.